What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Chris, and this is Product Reviews. We're coming at you today with a little bit different of a video, but I figured I owed you something more because of yesterday and that whole fiasco and whenever one didn't get recorded. So we're going to do something a bit different. Not totally different, but I've never shown you this process before. Basically, we're going to make some good food. Steak, but I'm gonna show you me seasoning it, prepping it, and getting it ready to go. And then I'm probably gonna throw in a few shorts while it's grilling, that kind of thing, because otherwise you'd be here forever watching this, and I don't think y'all are too interested in that. I do like to do them unedited. Technically, that would be unedited, but I'm not very fast whenever it comes to doing things. And shooting a video and doing things is gonna slow them down even more. So I figured the best thing to do is show you my prep process, what I like to do on not just steak, but just about anything. I mean, I put it on a lot of stuff. I don't think I put it on green beans or carrots. That'd be kind of weird. Maybe the seasonings, but not the other stuff. But I picked up two steaks. Not giant steaks, we're not small either. I figured I'd give this a good shot. I mean, I'm not no chef, but we're gonna take these two steaks. We're gonna put on a binder, and then we're gonna put them on the charcoal smoker out there at I don't know, either 180 or 200. I hadn't decided yet, and we're gonna cook them and see how they turn out. And from the point they leave here in the house and go out onto the smoker, that's probably where I'm gonna stop the video and then do some shorts here and there. So, with all that being said, let's go ahead and get into it a little bit. I'm gonna point y'all down if you don't mind so you can see what's going on here.
Gotta tighten you up so you don't fall over. All right, well, there we are.
You can see the steak's pretty good, or at least it looks like it from this point of view. The binder I have chosen to use.
Yellow mustard, specifically Heinz yellow mustard. It really doesn't matter the brand name, because about all yellow mustards taste pretty close to the same. There's subtle differences, but nothing major.
But I love using mustard. Mustard works great on all kinds of things. I mean, you can use really about anything for a binder. You can use just regular plain oil if you want to. Not motor oil. Don't cook with motor oil. Otherwise, your steaks, they're not going to be very tasty. I'll just put it like that. All right, so let's get some mustard on our meat. Close that up. I'll take a move this around. And these are freshly bought from the store, so there's no like pulling them out the fridge or the freezer and none of that stuff. Get this all over it. All on the edges and the sides and everything. I want it to cover it very well. You know, maybe if you like my cooking, you might hire me to come and be a chef for, you know, the afternoon. I don't know. Kind of isn't the worst idea in the world, but you know, at the same time, I wouldn't keep my fingers crossed. All right. For one of our seasonings, because we're going to shake it up a little bit. For one of our seasonings,
we're going to use, can you see that? No, holding it in the wrong spot. Red pepper. Instead of just regular pepper, we're going red pepper.
Yes, red pepper is a little more spicy, you got a little more kick to it, but we're changing it up some. So, you know, let's change it up some. stuff does not shake out very well. I need to put some bigger holes in this bottle. Break out the old trusted Craftsman grill. Or drill, I mean. I don't know, does Craftsman make a grill? Does anybody know? They make all kinds of stuff. Apparently. Or did. They make my darn tiller out there. It's old as the earth. You know, I messed up and used my right hand as my binder rubbing in hand. I'm not left-handed, and this feels kind of awkward.
Get some more off of the panel. All right. We can go with that on that side. Okay.
Now, final ingredient on a steak. I guess I probably shouldn't open it yet. You're not going to need much of this, or you're really going to overdo it. But we're going to change that up as well, and we're going to go with some garlic salt. Make sure that is what it says it is. Yes, garlic salt. Can y'all see that? I don't think I've ever done this combo before, but it should turn out pretty good. I mean, I'm going to sprinkle this from a pie. Okay, now we need, I'm going to pat it in. I ain't rubbing it in. Ain't doing none of that stuff. Moving it around. I'm going to pat it in. I hope you're all okay with that. That looks pretty good on that side. Now, let's repeat. Layer down. Layer down. Do this all left-handed because I'm a dummy. Rub a mustard in there again. Get her all mustardied up. Get her all coaty. Gotta get that stuff all over. Gotta cover your meat very well. Otherwise, what's the point using a binder? I'll tell you, probably my favorite seasoning I found, that's a new seasoning. I don't get it too much because it's, you know, not easy on the pocket, but it's that Dano's. That Dano guy makes some good stuff. Low sodium too. I don't care for a whole lot of salt in the first place. Y'all don't make fun of me and my technique here. Like I said, doing this with my left hand. So it's kind of weird. It does not work exactly how I want it to. Right hand, I could get busy with that joker. I know how to use it. But left hand, nah. I think that might be good enough for that. Let's go a little bit of this. Let's try it up high again because that's kind of nuts. There. That's all I want.
Get it away from that. Let's take some of it and sprinkle it over here in a little bit. Press it in.
press it in. I think that's pretty good. Wash my hand real quick. This will be the second time I wash my hands. This ain't got a damn ring away no more. It feels weird. Outside and get the grill started because I didn't do that before I did this. So
let's take. Do I got room to stick this in the fridge real quick? Just let it rest.
Y'all think I should put it in the fridge or the oven? We are gonna go.
No, got it right here. That's what we're going to do. There. That'll work for now. All right, let's go. Let's go get the oven. Or shit, the grill going. We gotta go grilling. Stuff everywhere. I've got to clean this up. Okay. Put you about right there. You should be able to see what's going on. First step to the burger. Take these out. Second step. Make sure you got charcoal. Might need to add some charcoal. Oh, by the way, if y'all buy this particular smoker, not Masterbuilt, unless you want to spend a fortune buying Kingsford all the time, get like B&B charcoal or something, natural charcoal. It lasts way longer. I'm gonna smoke something all day. You'll probably go through 15 bags of Kingsford. Whereas this, it don't take next to no time. Whereas with this, it lasts a long time. That's what I meant to say. Y'all like my dog food container, keep charcoal in. It's pretty cool. Charcoal is good. Open this up. Need to dump that out. Should get kind of full. Where she needs to be cleaned up and vacuumed out again. I'm not really surprised as far as that goes. Now,
ingredient. This is just to get the charcoal going. I'm not putting anything on until the charcoal is going. So in case y'all are wondering, oh no, he's burning stuff you're not supposed to burn. Well, you know, this was a tree at one time. Yeah, it's got all kinds of stuff on it now. But it's not going nowhere. So there's that. Some of you might say it's not a good idea because of all the ink. Well, I don't put anything on here until the smoke clears up, because that would just be very dumb. There's gonna be any more garden videos or not. I haven't thought I went through 100%, but I'm just gonna grow a garden for the family. I don't have that anymore, so don't seem like there's any reason to do it that way. I'm not putting that business out there. I'm just letting you know that I'm not keeping everything from you. And this is just the way things are. It's how the world works. Sometimes things do not go as planned. That's just what it is. Okay, now our next special ingredient. Lighter fluid. It doesn't always take that much lighter fluid. It just, it helps. Lighter. You should spread, even though this lighter did not want to light just then. There we go. Alright, y'all stand back. See it going there? It's kind of what we want. Put this at I'm gonna put it there. Are y'all ready? It ain't gonna take long to get 200. Just if it is, it gonna stay there.
That's not what you want to see. She's being stubborn. Doesn't want a light right now. That smoke's pretty insane. We're gonna take and give it a hand. Try it again. Come on, go. Fan keeps on blowing it out. It usually lights pretty daggone easy. Blowing it up. We need more heat than that. We need a lot more heat than that. She just ain't warm enough. She just ain't warm enough. We're gonna get it. We're gonna get it. We're gonna get her going. Get her done. It's very humid out here because it's been raining all day. So there's that as well. Don't ever do what I just did with the lighter fluid. Because of that. But it'll be alright. I'm actually getting kind of hungry too. I haven't eaten very well. I finally ate some ribs last night, but that's about it. Let that go for a second. We're gonna bring the temperature up and then bring her down. See if we can't get lucky enough this time. Oh yeah, she's going now. She's going now. Mm. And y'all see it? Yeah, she's going now. We gonna let her run. We gonna run. Finish getting the rest of this ready to go. So that we can enjoy the rest of our evening. Alright, put you back up. Oh. Rest of room temperature. They smell amazing. It's kind of strange considering they haven't even cooked yet, but whatever. I'm hungry. If I wasn't so civilized, I'd probably bite into it right now. And yes, in case you're wondering, it didn't exactly help the bank to go and buy these, but I'm hoping maybe it helps in the future. We'll see. I think we're gonna do some steak fries with it, because that'll just be simple. For those of you who do not know what steak fries is,
Lord help you.
I went and bought more potatoes than I have potatoes. Lord, Lord have mercy. Got the oar. Maybe something to spread it with. Boys did an amazing job cleaning that. We'll put it in here so they can get cleaned up a little bit. Spread the oar. We're gonna spread it with it. We can use the spatula, I reckon. Spread the air, the ear, the ear. You got the ear spread. Put the spatula in the dishwasher. Lord knows I ain't doing dishes today. Not yet, anyway. It's just me eating this, probably. So, I'm not gonna do many of these potatoes. Maybe, might do four. That just sounds like a good number. Four. Let's set it back up. And I need to not cut off my finger doing this like I tried to do the other day. I don't know. I don't think we're going to make these like traditional fries. I think we're going to do more like spuds or something. For those of you who don't know what spuds are, they are round French fries. Best way I can think to describe them. Right this second.
Probably have a better way.
No, I'm not peeling these. No, I'm not getting rid of the seeds. Both probably bad ideas.
But this is how we're doing it. This is my cooking show.
We're doing it my way. You don't want them too thick, because they'll take extra long to cook. Don't want them too thin, because they'll cook very fast. Also, try not to cut off my finger, because I am not Gordon Ramsay. Just hit the part of cut the other day. It didn't feel very good. Let's take these. Line them up on the plate or the pan, whatever. Whatever this thing's called. Alright, it's gonna take a minute. We'll put it towards the outside. Bam. Next. Oh, four might be too many. We'll see. In case anybody's wondering why I put them on the pan after I cut them, it is because I want to see how many I got so that I don't cut up too many potatoes or not enough potatoes or potatoes. Yeah, it's just basically seeing the amount I have and that's it. That is all. That is all with the Cooking with Chris channel. I mean, product reviews. Cooking with Chris, episode 2-1. I'm really trying not to cut myself because I did that the other day. It hurt. It did not feel good at all. Jesus. I'm making some fat boys over here. Some fat boys over here. You know, I put everything up, and now that I'm thinking about it, I should have freaking kept it out. You know, the pepper and the garlic salt, so that I could do these in that. Yes, four is going to be too many. So, what are we going to do with this guy? I'm going to put this guy to the side for now. Spin y'all this way. Got all that, so we're going to take it.
Dishwasher!
Don't be looking at my butt back there. Don't you do it. All you guys. Watch my shoe. Pepper, garlic salts.
See that technique, how much better it is with this hand. Now it's flip, 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 flip. Flip, 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 that would be fine. Flip. Flip, 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 and flip. All right, we're doing red pepper again. We're gonna leave the garlic salt on this time. Got it ready. Well, that tastes pretty good. I got a good bit of salt on my fingers.
Oven. Good bake. First gonna be 250. Let it start warming up.
I would imagine grill is about ready to go. The only way the grill wouldn't be is if for some reason the stuff went out, which I don't think happened. So we're gonna carry the sticks out with us this time, put them on, and I think that I am going to try to kind of sear them first. And then bring the temperature down. Because I cranked it up. Just to see where I'd end up at.
Let me run into my bedroom real quick. I'll be right back. Don't run over. Stay there. While I go here. Don't lock me out.
Okay. Wow, my hands are full. This thing here. Here we are. Near or far. Oh, Sheboygan. Let's pick y'all back up in there. I'll be looking down at my dirty floor. I don't look at your dirty floor. Gonna have to come back in and grab some things. It'll be okay. I'm gonna make it work. Ooh,
Do. Put it there. Put it there. Put it there. Yeah, that's about right. It's a little higher than what it should be, but it's about right. Damn it, I didn't grab a tongs. We'll figure it out in a second. Ladies and gentlemen, there's where the grill's at right now. It's kind of hovering and dropping. We're gonna put the steaks on that, and then we're gonna drop the temperature after we get both sides. There are the steaks. About to rock and roll here. There they are, in case y'all are wondering. Closing that back up. Alright y'all, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed cooking with Chris here on Product Reviews. My name is Chris, in case you didn't get that one either. Give it a big thumbs up on this video and many others. And we will see y'all next time. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, send a telegram, telegraph, tell a neighbor, tell a friend, phone a friend, all that good stuff. We'll see y'all next time. Peace out. Ah, come here.